Okay, so let's start. So today we just see the overview of how to use the Angular documentation. So Angular having their official documentation on a site angular.io. So you just click on this URL and click the Get Started button. Look here, you will get the documentation here. Other resources are available. If any other events related to the Angular, then it is available. The live events, the resources like in IDEs, Angular IDE by Web Eclipse, and IntelliJ IDE, Visual Studio Code, WebStorm. So these resources are available, and this
हेलो
is for the development purpose,
हेलो
for the education purpose.
फोन क्या था क्या?
The books are available.
हाँ ठीक
You can
है, फोन
go
हाँ फिर
through
मैं मंगा लेता
these books. Now
हाँ ओके ओके हाँ
community for the Angular, that is from the Russia, and then Angular in depth. So what is community? Basically, this is an open source, and who develops these languages, these technologies. So they work in the form of community, and they contribute to the technology. So basically, communities are available most of the time for the open source, okay, not for the licensed products. And now go to the documentation. This is important part. So you have a left-hand side, you have an introduction, then how to install the Angular, like a try it. Here you have a setup, and in a setup you have a prerequisite JavaScript, HTML, CSS. So how to install the Angular CLI, already we covered this part, right? And how to create the app, how to open the app, and how to start the server. So ngSer hyphen hyphen open, it is optional. If you type only ngSer, then also server works. Hyphen hyphen open means after server compiled your code, then automatically your browser starts your application. So that is hyphen hyphen open option, automatically opens a browser in the localhost 4200. Okay, so this is your landing page by default. You can customize it. Then these commands to create the components, we will say at the time of comp. Then inside this you have a main concept like the component template directives and dependency injections. So today we start the template. In a template, go to the introduction. So you have a, this is a template, is a chunk of HTML with a template. You can use a special syntax, leverage many Angular features. That means, so what is a template in a Angular? That is the HTML as well as some additional features which is given by your Angular, okay? And some special syntax are available for that template. So template is not straightforward HTML. So suppose this is my Visual Studio Code. Here you have the, this is app.component.html. It is a template, but along with the HTML, here you can type your Angular code also. So yesterday we have seen this is like string interpolation, right? So it's a name, and this name variable I already stored, this declared in the app component, right? So this is name, yes, and this is displayed on this HTML page. Just check it. I save the code. Look it. This is my name. Okay. So if you look the source code of this, look here, you are not getting any syntax related to your Angular application. So if anyone to hack your application using cross-site scripting language, then it is not easy to hack that application using client side techniques. Yes, so because the code is not available, only look here, app root is available, and using app root in your Angular, you are binded these many files, HTML file, TS file, okay, and your component TS. This is module, it is setting file, component and HTML, and you have another CSS file. So it is depends whether you want to give to the CSS or not. Okay, so now just come back to here template. Look here, so many template syntaxes are available, like interpolation, template statement binding syntaxes, property binding, attribute class style binding. So each and every details are available, and this is standard documentation which is given by Angular itself. And apart from that, whatever tutorials are available on an internet, so it may be having some different example, but the documentation is given by the Angular is a straight, it is a standard one, right? So it is recommended you to go through that documentation, like how we refer the Java documentation to learn the Java. Is it okay? Now I just go to the interpolation. Yesterday we have seen this example. So interpolation, string interpolation means what? It's a curly bracket starts, double curly brackets, and there you have to mention your string data. In the curly bracket, suppose you give the expressions, then also it gets calculated. Now suppose here customer, current customer name, you want to mention it, so current customer name is displayed. Only thing is, current customer, this variable, it should be declared in your TypeScript file like this. So here in a app.component.ts, I declared a name variable inside the class app component. Okay, and suppose here I give it, look, this is the value. This value may be static, that means it may be the hard coded, or you can take it from user, it depends on the requirement, we will see. But now here in this example, it is a hard coded value. Now just come back to your HTML, and I'm printing here curly bracket name. So this variable name and this variable name must be same. It is known as a string interpolation. Okay, and here you can now bind the HTML. Suppose I go like this, H2, is it okay? I remove this hello world, and now this app.component HTML having only H2 tag, which display the name, and here I just declare person name colon. Okay, I just try to customize it. So okay, that's correct. Now look at person name is Abhin, correct? Name space, person name is Abhin. So what about this? This is my first application. From which file it is coming? So it is coming from your landing page. So where is the landing page? index.html, and here we have, this is my first application, right? Suppose I want to remove this, you just remove it, and now you have only app root, and within app root you have a app.component, that is the template, and for a template you have a TypeScript file. This is your TypeScript code, and in a TypeScript class, this is app component class, you declared the name variable. So this is the string interpolation. Is it okay? Now using this string interpolation you can do such kind of things like you
वो
can
क्या
calculate the
करूँ
you can calculate the mathematical expression. So just check here. So mathematical expression, the sum of 1 plus 1, and here you are using the expression 1 plus 1 and it gets calculated and the output is shown on your screen. Now you just check it. Look at the sum is 1 plus 1 and it is 2. So basically this is a hard coded string. It is a hard coded string. Yes, and this is your expression. So mathematical expression 1 plus 1, whatever output is there, that's a 2, but this expression is given in your string interpolation. Suppose I try to change it 2 into 2 and check it. So string interpolation is used to represent a data from your variable, as well as it will help you to calculate the mathematical expression. Now check the output. This is the multiplication. Okay. Check. I saved this. Now multiplication of 2 plus 2 is 4. Is it okay? So when I save, immediately automatically it is compiled and then executes on screen, because already my command is running, that is ng-sur. So I have not terminated that terminal, that's why it is automatically saved. If you close the terminal again, you can fire the ng-sur and then it will work. Okay, so this is the first use. You can get the variable value from your TypeScript into the template, and you can directly give the mathematical expression and you can calculate it, or here you can use the variables and then you can calculate it. It is also okay. That means the variables are available in a TypeScript file. So this is a string interpolation. Is it okay? Now look at here the get value function is called, and this get value function, suppose available inside your TypeScript, then you can call here. Okay, so expression values such as get value in the following example, the angular evaluates all expression in double curly braces, converts expression result in a string and links them in a neighboring literal string. Finally, it assigns a composite interpolated result element or directive properties. So in this way you can concat using the plus. Whatever mathematical expression is there, it is calculated, and whatever the string is available, it is appended. So that many types of assignments you can do it using the operators. Okay, so you just refer this documentation for the different expressions. Now you have another use is like this. So you have to go with expression context. So suppose here heading tag is available and you have a variable, that is the instance variable of your component, and that value is pasted here, and this is known as the property binding. So what is a property binding? Property binding means for the HTML element, whatever the property is available, using that property you are binding the data. So how? I will show you. Now just come back to the source code. Now I remove this. Okay, and here I define one text. Okay, it's a text box, correct, and the value initially is suppose the empty. So it's just a text box. Now just come back to the output. So it is just a text box. Yes, so it is an empty text box. And now suppose for this value I want to display this name value. So how will display it? Can I do like this? Try it. Name Is it okay? So try it. Yes, it is displaying and it is editable. Yes, it's editable. But when you if you refresh it, automatically by default value is this. So it is a property binding. Yes. No, it is a string interpolation. Yes. So using property binding, how to display the name, I will show you. So you just remove this string interpolation and you go like this. This is a property binding. So you go with the square brackets, save this. So you are doing this in template. Now look, the data, same output is there. So the two different approaches, same output is here. One is using property binding, another is using string interpolation. Is it okay? Are you getting what I am saying? Yes. So it's a square bracket. This is a property for the input tag. So this should be inbuilt property. That means it is not allow you to customize it. So this is a value is a property for input tag, and for that you want to display the value of the variable which is declared in your component class. And this is the variable, it is instance variable of the app component class. Value is assigned here, and this value I want to display into the text box of the value attribute. Okay, is it okay? So what are the different syntaxes? Look, so I'm going with this value, right? Look, this is one. You have paragraph, so that is what first one. This is the mathematical expression, right? And you have the h1, and I define again another attribute, the title. So title I declare here, it's a first project. Okay, so title should be t small, compile it. Now look the output, it is a first project. Then sum 1 plus 1 is 2, and this is using your string interpolation, and this is your property binding. Here I use it br tag. Okay, so it will be more appropriate. Yes, first text box, second text box. So is it okay? So how to bind the data I using the string interpolation and property binding? If you have any doubt, you can ask me.